गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, माई सेल्फ पुरुषोत्तम पटेल, आई एम फ्रॉम ड्रीम इंडिया स्कूल रायगढ़ छत्तीसगढ़ एंड टूडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक ऑफ जियोग्राफी क्लास 10 एंड दिस इज चैप्टर नंबर 1 रिसोर्स एंड डेवलपमेंट. ओके, सो दिस चैप्टर इज इम्पॉर्टेंट, सो लेट अस स्टार्ट. वट डू यू मीन बाय रिसोर्स? रिसोर्स मीन्स एवरीथिंग दैट आर यूज by the humans for their needs, then this is called resource. Okay, resource may be culturally acceptable and economically feasible and technologically accessible. Okay, so resources may have the certain conditions. Okay, and the main definition of the resources: everything available in our environments that are used by the humans for their need is called resource. Okay, and the resource may be classified on the basis of the origin, exhaustibility, ownership and the developments. That means resource may be classified into four broad categories. Okay, so first we will classify the resource on the basis of the origin. On the basis of the origins, resource may be broadly classified into two types. First one is biotic and second one is abiotic. Biotic means those resources that have the lives, that means all the flora and fauna. Flora means vegetation and fauna means all the animals and the living organism. Okay, they have the lives and they belong to the biosphere, then this is called biotic. And all the non-living things, they belong to the abiotic. Okay, rock, metals, those not have any lives contained, then this is called abiotic. So this is the first classification of the resource. Okay, so second one is on the basis of the exhaustibility. Exhaustibility, renewable and the non-renewable. Okay, so these are the board classification. Renewable resources are the type of the resources that are renewed again. Okay, and the non-renewable resources are the types of the resources that are not renewed. Okay, renewable resources example all the sun rays. Okay, and the non-renewable example coal, petrol. Okay, so this is the definition of renewable resources and the non-renewable resources. Wind is the renewable resource, water is the renewable resource. Okay, and one of the important classification of the resource on the basis of ownership, on the basis of the ownership, resources may be broadly classified into four categories. First one is individual and second one is common and community based. Okay, and third one is national and fourth one is international. Okay, national and international resources are most important for us. Okay, so we will discuss one by one. First we will start from individual resources. Okay, so individual resources is important for us. So individual resources are the types of the resources that are used by individual only. Okay, and community based resource are the types of the resource that are used by the community, such as government hospital, government school is the example of the community based. Okay, our clothes are the example of the individual, that are used for the individual. Okay, or mobile phones. Okay, so one of the important concept is national and the international resource. First we will discuss about the national resource. National resource are the types of the resource that are used by the all the citizens that lives in our nation. Okay, so national resource example roads, canals, railways. Okay, all the minerals, water resources, forest, wildlife are the example of the natural resource. Okay, and one of the important concept is international resource. International resource are the types of the resource that are used in a international manners, that means are regulated by the certain international institute. These resources are regulated by the certain international institution, then this is called international resources. Exclusive economic zone is the example of international resources. Okay, exclusive economic zones, that means we share and utilize the ocean of 200 miles. Okay, from our boundary, our coastal boundary to the our ocean in a Bay of Bengal and Arabian Sea, we utilize the resources of 200 miles. So this is called exclusive economic zone. Okay, so this is the important concept and important classification of the resources on the basis of origin, on the basis of the ownership, on the basis of the international level. Okay, and again, this is the example of individual community. Garden is the example of the community based and individual our house. And railway is the example of the national resource and international exclusive economic zone. Okay. And on the basis of the development, resources may be classified into two categories. First one is potential resources. Potential resources are the types of the resources that are found in a region but not been utilized. Okay, so this is the example of potential resources. Example of potential resources is wind and solar energy in the Gujarat and Rajasthan that are known but that are not usable now. Okay, so developed resources are the types of the resources that are utilized by the any society and any peoples and governments. Okay, so this is called developed resources. Okay, and the next one is resources planning. When we utilize the resources, we utilize in a certain manner. For this manner, we need to make a plan. Okay, so plan is important to utilize the resources. So make a plan is important to utilize the resources. First, various stages of the planning. First one is to identify the better resources. Okay. And the second one is planning for exploitation. Okay, when we get the resources, we exploit, we make a plan for the exploiting. And the next one is compare the resources and in with a national development plans. Okay, so this is the three stages of the resource planning is important in a national level and international level also. And the next one is sustainable development. Sustainable developments means when we utilize our resources in a specific manner and we use a minimum resources and we create a maximum developments, then this is called sustainable development. It is important in our economy and in our country also. Okay, and the next one is resource conservation. When we utilize the minimum resources and maximum development, then this is the example of resource conservation. Resource conservation means when we conserve our resources and use of those resources that are not usable in a certain manners. Okay, that means we use a minimum resources and provide a maximum development, then this is called resource conservation also. Okay, that means the example of resource conservation, suppose we are using a cycle in respect of the bike. Okay, so this is the we consume the petrol resources. Okay, so this is the example of the resource conservation. When we travel to the small distance, we use the cycle in place of the bike. Okay, so we reduce the petrol. So resource conservation means we conserve our resources. Many types of the techniques for resource conservation. We use renewable types of the resources and we provide a recycle of the resources. We also provide a use of 3 R's concept. Okay, is also in a resource conservation. And the next one is Gandhiji also said about resource is important. When we utilize in a more and more resources in an uncertain manner, then your country will get destroyed. Okay, so Gandhiji is important. Gandhi's idea is important in a resource conservation. And the next one is soil is also important resource in our country. Soil is the upper thin layer of the lands, and soil made by the various types of the climate, various types of the factor. First one is climate, topography, nature of the parents rock, flora and fauna, time, vegetation, all the are the factor of the soil. So soil is the also important resource in of our country. Okay, so in this chapter we have discussed about the resource classification and how resource utilize and the sustainable development and how we can plan to utilize our resource and resource conservation. Okay, so this chapter is important for us. And next we have discussed about the syllabus of your next we will discuss the syllabus and a portion of your this. So this is your chapter, resource and development. Okay, so resource you already discussed, you already seen in slide. Resource is important, and resource may be classified into the different manner. So in this portion, define the what do you mean by resource. So resource is important. And the next one is natural resource. Natural resource is a type of resource that are made by naturally. And the human made resource is a type of resource that are made by human being. Okay, and human itself is a resource. Human have the proper skill and the knowledge, and this is called human resource. Okay, so resource may be three types: natural resource, human made types of the resource, and the human resource. Okay, and the next one is, this is the example of natural resource. Okay, and the next one is scientific perspective of the environments. Okay, so resource for our environments is also important. So the scientific perspective of the environments, which defines the importance of resources in our certain condition. Okay, so this is the important concept of the your chapter. Okay, so next we will discuss the natural resource. So natural resource we already cleared, okay, already defines in a slide. And we already defined natural resource is the type of resource that are made by naturally. Okay, so this is the your topic of chapter number 1. And the next one is renewable resource. Renewable resource is also important, that are renews. Okay, and non-renewable resource is also important. And the last one is resource management. Resource management means how to plan to utilize our resource and how to conserve our resource. Okay, so resource management first focus on alternative resource. Okay, when a small distance we travel by using cycle. Okay, so this is the alternative resource. And the implementation of the pollution control law, this is the second management technique. And the last one is equitable utilization of resources. Okay, so we use a equal way of all the resources. Okay, not using a single resource in a many different types of the resources we are trying to use. Okay, so this is the chapter of resource and development. I hope you are doing well and you also do your assignments. Okay, and next we will discuss your question answer also. Thank you very much to all of you.